when we were in Bolito, Colbin was given an SUP, a stand-up paddleboard, and it was a little wrecked, but we thought we would try resurrect it. So we posted it up to Saldanha when we left Bolito, and I hadn't seen it when Colbin had gotten it, and he was like, let's just post it. When it got to Saldanha, I didn't realize how much work there was involved to fix this thing up. It's a little bit broken, so we're trying to fix it up and we'll see if we can use it. We need one on the boat.
When you're on a budget?
When you're on a budget, you gotta make do with what you got.
So. This was for free, we're gonna see if we can make it nice.
Yeah. So watch these next few steps to see how to refurb an SUP.
A really bad SUP.
So we started off by sanding it down. Colbin had filled the top because there was a bit of a big gap area indentation. So he filled it with filler foam and then we fiberglassed over it. So my mom reinforced the sides and the top that had the filler foam. We had a little bit of a crack, as you can see through the fiberglass there, so we're just reinforcing it before putting another layer of fiberglass on top of this bare section. And then we went on to poly putty. So we used poly putty to ferret and get rid of as many holes and dents and dings and everything that we could have. And then that took about 2 or 3 times of poly putty and sanding, poly putty and sanding. And then when we thought it was ready enough, it's not perfect at all, but
we finished the first layer of fairing. I'm not entirely sure what we're using. I think it's called poly putty. So we fed a layer and sanded it down to almost perfection. And then we're going to go over with another coat. Now, so it's busy acetoning, cleaning the surface, and then we're A for away.
Then we went on to priming the board, and then we used 2K bow paint to paint it. So we think it's quite hardy stuff. And like I've said before, it's not, we don't expect like a perfect brand new SUP. We are really happy with how it's come out, and we did some drawing. We used paint markers and sealed the paint with an acrylic spray paint, so it protects it from the sun and the weather and everything like that. Because this was just a project, we didn't want to invest overly much money in it. So the SUP grips we found were like 2,000 Rand, which was like, I don't even know how many dollars. And that was just way out of our price range. So we ended up getting a yoga mat and we made a stencil with paper just to make sure that it was the right distance from the sides apart to cut it down. So it made it a lot easier. So we've cut the paper template that we will lay over the yoga mat and cut out. Make sure it goes to the top of them, that it's even on each side. Before we cut, just to make sure we've got the right shape.
Cut the yoga mat, and we're just trying to stick the yoga mat to the board. We don't want any contact adhesive sticking out from the other side of the mat. We're just going to tape it up and put the contact adhesive on both sides, yoga mat and board, and stick it down.
Glue it down. We used contact adhesive to glue the board and so we put some contact adhesive on the board and we put some on the yoga mat, and then we stuck it together, which wasn't easy, but with the help of my dad he helped us by lining it with paper and making sure, so you pull the paper out as you go just to make sure as you're sticking it down, so you're sticking it down, you're smoothing out all of the air bubbles that could be underneath there. So we are very chuffed with how it came out. We'll just have to test its durability. We worried about the yoga mat in the sun. We worried about the contact adhesive wearing out and not sticking anymore. But you know what? Way cheaper than buying a brand new SUP. So yeah, our latest addition on the yacht, and we are very happy with it. Colbin took it out for its first spin. With such perfect weather, everyone thought it was a good day for me to get behind the helm for the first time and try my hand at doing some maneuvers.
So you see the boat's already starting to turn now because you're only using that engine to propel you forward. Now you need to go back a bit on the starboard to 1500 RPM.
Getting used to having two separate engines can get quite technical, but it's so important to be able to pivot and not use steering or rudders in situations like small marinas where you need to be able to maneuver your way around without using big motions.
Effectively doing a U-turn. Yeah, if you're in a marina and you've got a very small area to maneuver around in to get to your dock.
See, now if you look at your weight, you're going faster on one engine than on the other.
So does it need to be equal?
But not necessarily. You don't want to turn this into a science. You just want to understand how it works.
Yeah.
Okay, so then...
How do you see where the wind is?
So on that control there...
This thing here will tell you when
you want your nose to be... Yeah.
So you can start slowing down. Neutral, because the boat will naturally.
So you're wanting to get. That's fine, you can do it with your steering. Okay.
So let's throw the buoy over, let her go out, turn around, and come back.
Sorry, Danny.
Okay, but first of all, let's head up so that you can. So just go forward throttle.
Yeah, just keep an eye on the power boat that's steering ahead.
But so go as fast as you're comfortable.
Yeah, we're watching.
No, we just first of all just taking. It's not man overboard yet. We just want Tegan to go up, turn around, and come back because remember she hasn't even really steered much yet.
Come back into neutral. Then what you're going to do is you're going to put your port engine into forward. Port side on the left. Forward.
Quite far forward.
Quite far forward because now you're being pushed by the wind.
Yeah. Back on the other one.
Yeah.
So now you're effectively trying to turn your boat around and go back that way.
Without the steering.
Yeah. If it was man overboard, I think you'd just be using your steering. But for now, we just... Danny's behind us, he's drowning, but at the moment we're just learning the controls, so it's all good. Okay. Let's just let her get up against him. We're not going to worry about whether it's into the wind or against the wind, or you just want to get as close to the buoy as you can. Okay, so slow down now because you're just going to keep going. Pull the back one up again. Okay. So now, can you see the thing there? You're getting close. Okay, but now the wind is just swiveling us. Oh, it's right up against the boat. And Danny is saved.
We ticked off another small job on the list where Colbin had to go up the mast and put up the block and tackle for the courtesy lines. So we've got our courtesy flag lines up, we just need to find the flags now. Thank you for watching with us. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a like, and if you have any questions or input on our stand-up paddleboard, please leave them below.